Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about linear equations. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to try to find an equation for the line containing the points negative 2, negative 7, and 3, negative 5. And once we find that equation, we're going to express that equation in slope-intercept form. So let's go ahead and just define what slope-intercept form looks like. And that's y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope. The slope is also sometimes called rise over run. And the variable b is the y-intercept, and that simply is where the line crosses the y-axis on our coordinate plane. First thing we need to find is our slope. The slope is not actually given to us, but we can derive the slope based on the two points that we have here. But first, let's go ahead and actually label each one of the coordinates on these points. We're going to label this first point x1, y1, and the second one x2, y2, where x1 corresponds to negative 2, y1 corresponds to negative 7, x2 corresponds to 3, and y2 corresponds to negative 5. Now let's take a look at what the actual equation is for finding the slope. That equation is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. And now we're going to go ahead and substitute those values in place. y2, we define that as being negative 5, minus y1, that's being defined as negative 7. Again, be sure to use the parentheses because we don't want these two negatives to mess us up when we're dealing with our signs. x2 is defined as 3, and x1 is defined as negative 2. And again, let's use those parentheses so that we keep our signs in order. Let's look at our numerator and begin to evaluate. We have negative 5, and then we have a negative times a negative, and negative times negatives gives us a positive. So we have a positive 7. In our denominator, we have 3, and again, we're multiplying a negative times a negative, and that there will give us a positive 2. Now we're going to go ahead and evaluate the numerator. Negative 5 plus 7 is a positive 2. In our denominator, 3 plus 2 gives us 5. So we know our slope is 2/5, where we're going to rise 2 and then run 5. Now that we have the slope and we have a couple of points, we can use a formula known as the point-slope formula. Point-slope formula is defined as y minus y1 is equal to m times the quantity x minus x1, where y1 and x1 can be either point negative 2, negative 7, or point 3, negative 5. Doesn't matter which one, because we've actually shown the relationship between those two points based on the slope. I'm going to go ahead and choose the first point, negative 2, negative 7. Rewrite the equation. Y minus y1 is defined as negative 7. Again, use those parentheses. Equal to m, which is defined as 2/5. X minus x1, which is defined as negative 2. And as you see, I still use that extra set of parentheses to keep everything straight. Y a minus times a minus gives me a positive, equals 2/5. X a negative times a negative gives me a positive 2. And like I said, I'm trying to get everything into this y-intercept form here. So I want it in the y equals form, which means I need to subtract 7 from both sides. That leaves me with y is equal to 2/5 x plus 2 minus 7. Now I'm going to distribute this 2/5 to my x term and my positive 2 term. So that gives me 2/5 x plus 2 times 2 gives me 4. And it's understood to have a denominator of 1, so 5 times 1 is 5 minus 7. Here I have two numbers, a fraction and a whole number. I need to combine those two numbers. So I'm going to continue up here. So I have 2/5 x plus 4 plus 4/5. Then I have this negative 7. I want to change the form of this negative 7 into an improper fraction, which is still going to be equivalent to negative 7, but placing me in a form where I can add two fractions together. I know my denominator I want to have is 5 because that matches what I have here. And I know that 35 divided by 5 is going to give me 7. So this here is the equivalent fraction. Now I'm going to go ahead and evaluate those two fractions. 4 minus 35 gives me a negative 31. And I keep my denominator as 5. So my equation for the line expressed in slope-intercept form is y is equal to 2/5 x minus 31 over 5. I want to go ahead and thank you for watching Spell Tutorial Services here on the YouTube channel or either on our Facebook page. And please be on the lookout for more videos to come. Thank you.